Hi, this is Sean with the Billings National Weather Service office. In this short presentation, I will explain some of the basics of Doppler Weather Radar Reflectivity data. The different colors that we see on reflectivity products represent the amount of power, which is measured in decibels, that is returned to the radar by an object. Areas of heavy precipitation with big raindrops, hailstones, or snowflakes return a lot of power to the radar and appear as brighter colors in reflectivity images. In the reflectivity image shown here, the heaviest precipitation is in red, while lighter precipitation is in blue and green. The location of the Billings Doppler Weather Radar is indicated by the small blue letters KBLX inside the black circular region. As we can see, the storm east of the radar is hook-shaped, indicating that it is very well organized and likely contains some rotation, the precursor to a tornado. In this case, the storm did produce a tornado, so the hook shape here was a tornadic signature. But we cannot say with certainty that a storm contains a tornado just because it has a hook shape. We must look at other Doppler weather radar products, and we must try to get confirmation from someone close to the storm to be sure. If the colors on reflectivity images are getting brighter with time, we know that a thunderstorm is growing stronger. This indicates that more power is being returned to the radar as the raindrops and hailstones grow larger and precipitation becomes heavier. In this animation, centered on the Billings Doppler radar, there are several thunderstorms intensifying very rapidly while others dissipate just as quickly. Each time step in this animation represents an interval of just under 5 minutes. Please join me for the next lesson. I will have more on Doppler weather radar reflectivity products. Remember, radar data on our website can be accessed by clicking on the radar image towards the bottom of the main page. Thanks for your time.